help in retracting the cylinder. For the double acting cylinder, you have two ports. Okay, you can see as in this figure, you have the port A and port B, which are connected, as you know, P to A and P to D, wherein the oil is present everywhere in the system. Okay, so that based on the TCV position, we are going to decide the working of the cylinder, that is whether it is an extension stroke or it is a retraction stroke. Okay, so now what are the common things? We are going to have a slight analysis in the sense it is just you are understanding how the cylinder force, velocity and power are defined. So if you consider here, during extension of a double acting cylinder, the amount of oil that has to enter into the annular space here is nothing but this complete space that we call it as blind end or blank end. Okay, and this end is called as rod end. Okay, so at the right side you have a piston rod, and here the area is different and here the area is different. Now what is that difference? If you observe here, Q in, that is inlet oil, okay, oil inlet, the oil has to fill this complete space here. Not only this, but as the piston goes on moving ahead during the extension stroke, till this end, what will happen? Oil will fill here. But during the retraction stroke, if you observe, what will happen? During the retraction stroke, the oil, the quantity of oil that is needed to fill the complete space is lesser as compared to the one which we need for during extension. What is that difference? Can anyone tell me why the oil required here is less and why the oil required here is more? Am I audible? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Can sir, anyone? So the rod will consume some volume that will reduce the requirement of oil.
Exactly. So here the concept here is you have the total area that has to be filled by the oil or the volume, okay, or the space which has to be occupied by that oil is nothing but this piston area minus the rod area, or we can denote them as AP. If it is AP, then it is piston area. If it is AR, it is rod area. So the total area or the total volume that has to be filled with the oil is lesser here compared to the total volume that has to be filled here. Here what will happen? Only AP is there. Okay, area of the piston, complete area of the piston is there, okay, multiplied by this length. But here it is area of the piston minus area of the rod. So during extension, more oil is required to push this piston to complete the extension stroke. Okay, during retraction, less quantity of oil is supplied. Okay, then now during extension, the entire piston area that is shown in shaded region is exposed to fluid pressure, correct? But during retraction, some area is subtracted. What area is subtracted? The area of the rod is subtracted. Okay, that is what is to be understood here. With this understanding, let us go for the force, velocity and power. So the output force, okay, if it is denoted by F, the velocity of the piston as V for a double acting cylinder, this output force and velocity are not the same during extension and retraction strokes. Okay, they are different. Fine. So which is higher and which is lower, let us analyze. During the extension stroke, as you can see here, if F external force is denoted in newtons, the force that is required is nothing but pressure into area, because pressure is force upon area. So the pressure, if you define in pascals, area here we are considering, what area is to be considered? Area of the piston. Okay, so pascal meter square. So this will be the component of force that you need to extend the cylinder. What about the velocity? Velocity is defined as discharge upon area. Okay, so discharge, if you represent in terms of meter cube per second, and the area, again here, the area that we consider here is area of the piston. Why do we consider area of the piston? Is nothing but this area. Piston is here, so this complete area has to be considered. So the expressions for force is nothing but P into AP, and expression for velocity during extension is nothing but Q in by AP. Let us see for retraction. During retraction, as I had explained to you, you can see the shaded portion. So the oil that is needed to fill this portion is definitely lesser. So what will happen during retraction? Only the annular area around the rod, that annular area around the rod will be what? Can you see here this shaded portion? This area will be minus, subtracted. So it will be AP minus AR. AP is nothing but area of the piston, this complete piston minus area of the rod. So this will give you the remaining area. So that which is shown in shaded is exposed due to fluid pressure. So what happens to your expressions then? So the expressions will simply change as the F, the force that is needed for retraction, is nothing but P into AP minus AR, and the velocity during retraction is nothing but Q in, okay, upon AP minus AR. So from this, what you can conclude? We can conclude that here, since it is AP, okay, and here it is what? AP minus AR. So definitely will that quantity or the value of area will be definitely lesser. If that denominator is decreased, what happens to this velocity? Increases. Hence, we conclude that the velocity during retraction is higher than the velocity during extension for a double acting cylinder. So the question for you that can be asked with regards to this is that analyze or explain the concept of velocity during retraction is higher than the velocity during extension. So based on this, one question can be asked. Okay, so prove that or explain the concept of higher velocity during retraction compared to extension. Okay, so this can be a kind of an open-ended question or whatever it is. So you have to answer this. So extension force is definitely greater than the retraction force for the same operating pressure. This has to be kept in your mind. Operating pressure is same. For the same pressure, the extension force is greater than retraction force, and retraction velocity is greater than the extension velocity for the same input flow rate. Okay, so I hope this concept is clear for you all. This was a small bit of analysis, or you can say the expressions that you are supposed to remember. Based on this, there can be a question that can be asked, and the question will be definitely a substitution type of a question. Okay, nothing difficult as such. Okay. So this is what you have to understand with regards to the cylinder force, velocity, fine, and power. How do you define the power? So the power, you are getting it as an expression of V into F by this value, or you can calculate it as V into F or discharge into pressure. So you just remember this equation so that you will be able to calculate the power in, suppose if we ask. Most important thing is this, okay, to prove that the retraction velocity is greater than the extension velocity for a double acting hydraulic cylinder. Okay, so this is what is with regards to single acting and double acting cylinder. Now let us switch on our understanding for the next set of circuits. So still we are left with different circuits, like we have regenerative cylinder circuit. Then we have again meter in circuit, meter out circuit. Then we have the sequencing circuit, counterbalance valve application, double pump hydraulic system, and so on. So hardly around 4-5 circuits are remaining still. So we will take that one by one. Today we will complete regenerative cylinder circuit. Okay. So now let us understand what is this regenerative cylinder circuit and what is that concept. Me just take you to the slide. Give me a minute. I will present the PPT now again. Are you able to see this PPT? Can anyone confirm? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now the next circuit that you are supposed to study is the regenerative cylinder circuit. Now, first of all, what do you understand by the word regenerative? Regenerative means use that same oil again, regenerate it. Okay, just you can have a circuit in which you can save time and energy. Now, how you can save the time and energy? By increasing the extension speed of a double acting cylinder. Now, just now we understood by the earlier concepts that generally the retraction speed, that is the retraction velocity, is higher than the extension velocity. So in order to increase the extension velocity, what can be done? To do that, we can use a concept of regeneration of the oil. Okay, now what is that concept? How do they do this? They do it by routing the fluid, or making that fluid which is exiting from the rod end of the cylinder back to its cap, instead of routing it to the tank. So in your regular double acting cylinder, what is happening? Just let us analyze it before we go here. In your double acting cylinder, I hope all are able to see the circuit. What is happening? In the neutral position, everything is standstill. Pump is unloading to the tank through the PRV. Okay, next, in during the extension stroke, what is happening? Oil from pump passes from P to A and enters the blank end of the cylinder here. Okay, and oil which is already present in the rod end goes back to the tank. If you observe here, it goes back to the tank. Fine. And during retraction, what happens? It will be the opposite, that is, this envelope will be connected. So oil from P will flow to B and it enters the rod end of the cylinder and starts pushing the piston to retract, and oil which is present in the blank end of the cylinder is taken back to the tank. This is what is your general arrangement for regular double acting cylinder. Just imagine if the oil which is exiting here, instead of taking it back to the tank during extension, I am talking about during extension, oil will be entering here, okay, and the oil which is exiting, instead of taking wire or the tank, if we close this port B, okay, and connect this back here, what can happen? Can anyone tell me? If I connect this directly to this A line, channel A line, which goes to blanket, what can happen? Yes, I'm waiting for your answer. Can anyone speak something? Am I audible? Yes. Can anyone tell? Yes. Can anyone give an answer, or all are off the screen? Fine, leave it. So what happens here is, since you can you connect this outlet of the rod end back here for which is connected to the inlet of the blank end, oil will get regenerated quickly. Oil supply will be there. There will be no oil that will be taken from the pump. Hence, the speed slightly increases during the extension. Okay. So basically, regenerative cylinder circuit helps in increasing the speed of extension of a hydraulic cylinder. Okay. Remember this. Now, how that happens? Just observe here. This is the circuit that you are supposed to draw. Okay. So you have this port B, which is blocked, and we have the connections as shown here. As usual, it is same for double acting cylinder. So if you observe what happens, oil from the pump during extension, I'm talking, will enter the blank end of the cylinder, and the oil from the rod end is, instead of taking it to the tank, is connected to the pressure line. Okay, so it suddenly gets ready. You can show the connection here, or you can show the connection directly here. Both mean the same for us. Okay, so directly it gets added up. Hence, the speed of extension increases during the extension stroke. And retraction stroke is same. There is no change in the operation of the retraction stroke of the hydraulic cylinder. Is it clear? Okay, this is what is your regenerative cylinder circuit operation. Okay. It is one of the important circuits which you are supposed to understand and study. Is it clear? Now, some more explanation is here. So, this diagram, again, it is the same. Okay. So, same concepts have been explained here. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, we are able to see only one single diagram, sir. Means we are not able to see a pointer or anything, sir.
No, that is the problem, because the background is white. No, that is why you are not able to see this pointer. That will happen. But you don't worry. You just try to connect it to the explanation rather than that arrow or the pointer. I think that should be okay. And you people are familiar with the terms right now. Blank end, rod end, pump, pressure line. So just follow those words. I think that is a problem every time, because this background is white. Don't worry. That should not matter.
Sir, this you are showing now double acting cylinder or different one, sir?
No, this is a regenerative cylinder circuit. You can see the port B block.
So now we are able to see that double acting cylinder only, sir.
Okay, 1 minute. Just give me a minute. Just confirm. Okay, just see. I'll make full screen.
So now it is changed.
Now it is changed. Okay. No, I think there is some lag in the slide changing, maybe.
So now when you change it to full screen, we are not able to see the changes what you have done.
Oh, now which one you are seeing? Port B is blocked. Can you see that cross mark?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then it is regenerative cylinder circuit. Correct. Okay. Yes. So now we are going to have this operation as explained, like during the extension and during the retraction. That is what it is. Now let us understand this through the concept of a video. Okay. Today we are going to study only this regenerative cylinder circuit. And another three circuits are there, which we will take it up in the next class, because otherwise it will get over. So let me take you all to a video wherein you can understand the operation of a regenerative cylinder circuit. Give me a minute. Just confirm if you are able to see the video. Okay, I am presenting now. Give me a minute. Present window. Are you able to see this video?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This regenerative flow, correct? That person is explaining GPM. This one you are seeing, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this video explains us the concept of regenerative cylinder circuit. Actually, this is an industrial explanation. That's why I put it. Let's hear to him. Okay. 1 minute. I'll increase the volume. It's mute. Okay. One second. Yeah.
Sir, not able to hear, sir.
1 second, I will increase the volume. Just see now. Is it okay?
No, sir. No sound.
All right. 1 minute. I will increase the system volume also now. It's 72. I am making 9900. Just confirm, okay? Full screen. This volume also 100. Just confirm if you are okay with it.
No, sir, still no sound.
Still no? Then I think your system volume has to be increased. I don't have any problem from my side. No?
It's not audible.
Surprising. Oh my God.
No, sir, no sound.
Not audible? Mm-hmm. 1 second. Just let me go to here. No, the audio settings are not there. That's why I hear nothing audio setting. Just see if it is okay. Otherwise, just look at the video. I will upload this link also. So you can again view it. Okay. I will on this. Confirm if you are able to see this. Yes. Are you able to see this?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay, just observe. Later I will just upload the link so that you can see it in your mobiles.
SBI cards and payment services is currently. Vodafone Idea is currently.
So I hope you are able to understand. Okay, this is a retraction wherein the connection is not given here, because if it is given here, then you cannot retract it. So that is why the connection has been given over here. Okay, so that during extension, as shown here, what will happen during extension? The oil will start entering over here, and the oil from the rod end adds up to this flow line, so that more flow rate, hence faster extension. But for retraction, what can happen? You can observe here, for retraction, once you shift the lever, you can have the flow rate from here, and the oil which was present in the blank end will return back to the tank. Okay, and here itself it will get added and will retract the piston. Okay, is this clear? So I think your CIE has been postponed, and I think it is starting from 30th of this month. So for CIE, I hope the portions are clear. You will be having unit 3, that is part B, that is hydraulics, introduction to hydraulics and hydraulic systems and all those things, plus unit number 4, correct? So both are there. The paper is simple, nothing to worry as such. You have to understand the circuits, and you have to sketch and explain. Please remember, you have to sketch the correct diagram, okay, of the valve or whatever it is. All the diagrams are there in the PPT, and the explanation you can make it point wise. Don't write paragraphs together. Okay, so is it clear? Any doubts? Just give me a minute, I will take the attendance, and then you can leave. Don't leave till I take the attendance. So that's it for today. Nothing much. We are left with another 3-4 circuits, and then we are going to hand over the classes to fluid machines. What is the portion coverage in fluid machines part? Can anyone tell me? Yes, please. Hello. Am I audible? Are you listening?
So those triangular diagrams after Euler's equation and numericals on that.
Okay, fine. So your unit number 2 is going on, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Almost so, end of unit 2.
End of unit 2, yes. He had requested for classes. So what we have planned is, we can have the classes we will be giving after the next week. Anyway, you have next week, you have IA. From December 1st or so, he will only take over. Because fluid power part is easy. You can remember, understand and reproduce. That's not an issue at all. But fluid machines is completely analytical, and you need to, the concepts are slightly difficult. So that is why we are giving the classes to him, so that he can revise if you want and so on. Okay. One minute. I'll just log in through. Login through Chrome, and then I will take the attendance. Okay. Here the attendance icon is not activated. That's why. I'll do that. Okay, I think I've taken the attendance, so you all can leave the meeting. Any other things to be discussed? point.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. Thank you.